Good Sunday afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. You know who I am, the D-O-U-G here. And it's time to get back to the last Tinker City of Colors. True Colors. Yeah, I'm not singing today. And when we left off previously, we were in the tower, the lion's den. So let's go. The Tower of Power. Or is it the Twin Towers? Are we gonna face Akeem and Big Boss Man? So this is what Paris Hilton's vagina looks like. Ah, Cyclops. What happened to this once beautiful and magnificent place? This is exciting! We should explore each and every corner! No way, no time for that. We need to find Purple. Go! Upsetting from that for me, you know, I always liked Cody Rhodes. I bet he's in the gallery. That's what probably. Now, of course, a lot of people are thinking, oh, maybe it's just him and not Stardust, but then I gotta remember, or most of us do, that him and Stardust are the same fucking person. So it's sad that he is gone. You're back, and you brought some old friends. That's good. Destroy you all! Papa, you have to stop. This is madness. No, this is Colors! Let's be friends again, okay? Ready or not, we're coming in! Yes, come in. The last memories of Color Town will disappear forever, along with you. Wow, somebody really tiptoe through the tulips with me. Huh? What was that? Huh. Probably nothing. And, well, that was anticlimactic. Game over. What happened? I think Papa has eaten us. What? But that leaves the question. Where are we right now? Well, that can't be good. It appears that Papa has trapped us somewhere in the dreamscape, which means he wins, we lose. Oh no, we're not giving up that easily. I have a feeling this place is more than just a prison. Let's explore it. That sounds quite reasonable. Woohoo! Explore! Ah, great. So we're in a stomach. Ah, that's just Fiji. So you can either get the jump blue attack, the normal punch upgrade, the hard punch upgrade, power. Good. Oh, we do need that. Most likely he'll probably be released after tonight. Number one, right? Hey, which color is the best? A good question to be sure. That's what did it. Greed. Anger. Sadness. Fear. Anyone want to make some colors? That's why he did it. He felt forgotten because he doesn't have his own community. Then the three brothers decided to be a little assholes and decided to fight each other to see who's the best. That was truly depressing. I can't remember any of that. I wonder what's next. That is a great question. How could this have happened? I hate the others. Why would you say that? I'm scared of the others, but you don't have to be. And that is true. The others make me sad. I don't understand. So... Popo's pissed because no one would listen to him, and he's mad at his three brothers because they ended up fighting. Welcome to the weird world, Popo. Can do is watch. Oh yeah, then we'll do the same. Because they're stupid. Ha! Here! Ha! Just checking to make sure they don't put no random paintbrushes in here, because they could be dicks. There must be some sort of remedy. No cure can mend a broken people. Is there nothing we can do? Well, you can sing, "Hey, Macarena." Yes, but nobody will listen to us. Ah, okay. You know there had to be unity, but since none of the other three communities will listen to it because they're fucking assholes. Because no one wants to listen. So the blickness must be his evil side, I guess. But I can't really be mad at public because it wasn't technically all his fault. Not his brothers became dicks. Do you see now? The city is broken. From the very basis of its idea. Was it really like this? Why can't we remember? Maybe because we don't want to. So you want to destroy the city? Because people don't get along together? I did everything I could to fix the city. But if nobody listens, then all that's left is misery. No color, no life worth living. The only way is to destroy the city. Add the last memory of Color Town is gone. Maybe someday someone will have a better idea for a city of colors. You really don't get it, do you? Huh? I said you don't get it. There's no need to destroy anything. You have already fixed the city. I don't understand. Okay, you showed us memories. Now let me show you something. Just hop in a corn's backpack and clear away this bleakness mess, will you? It's not as dangerous. Yeah, open the gate for him. This time for Sulkin is past. Protect the city. Your people needs us. Happened all over Color Town. After the Bergness attacked the city. How? You put Color Town through some dark times. I guess it's what people needed to finally wake up. Sure, some of them needed an extra push or two. But in the end, they all forgave the problems and remembered what was truly important. Do you get it now, Papa? Are they together again? I saved them! Well done, brother. All you have to do now is end your current campaign of destruction. Yeah, just call off the bleakness, bro. What? I can't call off the bleakness just like that. Why not? You're the bleak spirit. The bleak spirit is the only part of me I gave to the bleakness when I called it. He put me in this bleak dream. I knew, but I didn't care too much about. Okay, but how do we stop him? He is waiting in the eye of the bleak storm, on top of the Tower of Color Town. If the spirits combine our powers, I can take us there so we can face him. I guess that's as good as a plan as we get. Very well, siblings. Let us all combine our powers. Ooh, combine! How do we do that? Just follow Popo's lead. It's what he does, after all. I have the power of purpleness. I'm now the mascot for the Pottermore Ravens. Now let us show you our true power. Imagine a way to the tower, then press X. Well, now go through that portal we created. I think he just killed me. I think he physically just killed me. I'm too old for this. The bleak spirit must be here somewhere. So we're literally in the eye of the storm. Hey, this looks like a boss arena. No shit. Where is that big white coward? That is a good question. Town painting, he has power over the city. We have to get it back and colorize it. It's the only way to save the city. I won't allow that. What are you anyway? I am the bleakness. I am part of the Temple War. I exist to erase broken ideas, so the new ones can replace them. I am called by those who fall victim to the cruelties of life. I never mean. Don't listen to him, Gorn. Together we are strong enough to defeat him. That's just what I wanted to say. Oh guys, let's do this. The power of color will prevail. Do you guys have a plan? Yeah, we're gonna call Rainbow Bright because she's smarter than the dumb monkey boy. Last time he took us in one fight. Wait for an opportunity to use my power. Your imagination will do the rest. This is it, Gorn. The final test. Show him what it means to be a tinker. Okay, so now we know the point of the boss battle. Okay, blah 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 blah. something in this boss battle's probably gonna take a while. And the homing missiles can go fuck off.
Yeah.
balls and bullshit. There. I just saved us 5 seconds. More homing missiles. Either that or the booger's out of his ass. It's flying shit. Homing shit. Good to know. Make sure they have that in the next Wolfenstein. Shit that is no pooping at homes at your home. Damn it! God, he's doing the swimming. Oh, one more hit away. That is some bullshit. Painting actually looks pretty beautiful, actually. And now the world is returning. We did what Rainbow Bright could never do. We actually made sure colors came back. And while this long-ass cutscene plays, I'm going to go to the kitchen to make me a sandwich.
City was in bad shape, but hey, it's Tinkerworld, remember? All you need is color, paper, glue, and teamwork. Sort of. After they got some sense knocked into them, people did a great job rebuilding Color Town. Purple even has his own district now. All in all, things turned out pretty well. Or did they? Yeah, they did.
And that, ladies and gentlemen, has been my Let's Play of The Last Tinker City of Colors. If you sat through this with me from beginning to end, I thank you for that very much. Not a bad game, I gotta say. It's been a fun game, I gotta say, you know, which kind of surprised me overall. Overall, though, I'm gonna talk about the game a little bit more. I'm gonna give this game a good score. I'm actually gonna say it's a 3.5 out of 5. I would definitely recommend it, you know, if you can get it for cheap, if you can. Because while it's not the hardest game of the world, it's not easy either, you know? It's kind of one of those happy medium games we can all enjoy and be happy with. Now, of course, off-screen, I will be heading back to finish up 100%ing this game. But the trophies ain't really that difficult either if you're following a trophy guide. So, I hope you've enjoyed this. And until next time, this is the DOUG signing off saying thank you for watching. I hope you've enjoyed. And I'll see you next time. Hey, and look, I clocked in under 7 hours on this game. It's pretty good to me. Till then, I'll see you Tuesday for Mortal Kombat. And finally getting back to Wolfenstein. The New Order. Till then, have a good Sunday.